How are we doing, Matty, with this boiler?
We're not doing too bad. First thing this morning, we took the boiler template out, put it up against the wall, corners flew out, then hung the boiler, which is on a back jig, put the flue in. That just needs cementing up, can do that later on.
Can see that's a nice neat hole up there.
Just getting pipe working now, just fit a TF1 filter to catch any debris going into the boiler. And
what's that laser line for? Can see we're using a laser level, what's that for?
It's to get your pipe works level as you drop them down and they come out of the boiler, and as they go up, they're going to come up across here onto this uni strut.
Yeah.
And run all the way along the roof. As you can see.
Yeah, can see that.
It's going to go a bit further down here.
Yeah.
Into the house and then into the existing heating system.
I can see that this is in a garage, this boiler and the pipe work. So what are we going to do about frost protection in there, Matty?
What's going to happen is once we've completed all the pipe work, we're going to fit Honeywell frost protection on the system, and that'll prevent it from freezing up in bad weather conditions.
This pipe work's going to get lagged as well.
Yep.
So yeah, the Honeywell frost protection kit, that's a frost thermostat in this room, connected to a pipe thermostat. And basically,
hi, it's Paul Daly from Daly Plumbing and Heating. I just wanted to show you this boiler installation that we've done. We've done a system conversion from stored hot water gravity tanks to mains pressure system combination boiler. The boiler is fitted in the garage. The original boiler was fitted inside a kitchen cupboard. So you can see that we've lagged the pipe work, but that may not stop it from freezing. So on the boiler and the boiler pipe work, what we've done is, if you look here, we've fitted a Honeywell pipe stat, and that pipe stat is linked to the Honeywell frost thermostat. And basically, if the temperature in this room drops down to 3 degrees, the Honeywell frost thermostat, regardless of what the room thermostat is saying, will fire the boiler. Once the boiler return flow temperature has reached 25 degrees, it will turn the boiler off. So it's not going to heat up the whole house. All it's going to do is send a slug of warm water around the heating circuit and prevent the pipes from freezing. As the temperature cools, the pipe stat, if the frost stat is still wanting heating, will basically tell the boiler to fire again. And once it gets to 25 degrees, it'll turn off again. And that's how the system works. So on this system, we've fitted the Thernox TF1 filter on the return pipework before it goes into the boiler. And we've fitted a Viessmann 35 kilowatt combination boiler. Now the boiler's stood off the wall because the pipework passes up the back of the boiler. So we've used the Viessmann standoff frame, which also comes with this bottom section, which conceals the pipe work under there. If you're interested in a boiler installation or you want a quotation, then give us a call. My details are at the bottom of the screen. Thank you.